Welcome back, everyone, to Pokémon FireRed with Gameonwithsean. I'm Sean, and today we are going to be battling Brock at the first gym, so let's get a move on. This guy, don't want to talk to him, he just tells me a bunch of boring stuff. There's Brock, but we'll first have to fight that guy. Stop right there, kid! You're 10,000 light years from facing Brock, but Brock is literally 4 steps in front of me! Crazy guy right there. Camper Lion, or whatever his name is, wants to battle. Sent out Geodude. If you have Bulbasaur or Squirtle, these battles will be super easy. Use Grass Head Patch. Watch. Shwa! Done. Super effective. Next Pokemon he will have is the Sandshrew. I recommend changing to your Spearow, if you do have it, just for the sheer fact, much better than Bulbasaur attacking, and he's not weak to those things. I'm a little higher level than him. He's gonna use the that's sort of stupid defense play. I'll peck again. He was using Defense Curl. I'll try out Fury Peck. Or Fury Attack, sorry. Since it is, that's a normal move. I'll try it. See if it does more damage. Not at all. Oh, okay. 3 times, that's good. Scratch. Oh, that's gonna take some damage. I'll use Peck again. And okay, he's using Defense Curl. If he does start attacking you, use Growl to drop his attack and use Leer to drop his defense. But he's using Defense Curl. Oh my goodness. That must be good 1 HP. Yeah. But he fainted. He gained a ton of experience there. Grew to level 14. As you can see, those are my stats now for Spearow. Player defeated the Camper. Darn! You wearing your short pants. Light years isn't time, it's a measure. It measures distance. And that is actually true. Sean got 250 Pokédollars, so good for me. Well, if you guys are playing too, good for you. Right now, I'm going to go in my bag, and I'm going to use a potion on Spearow, even though I really don't have to. You know what, just in case he gets lucky with his Geodude and his Onix. You know what, who knows. So you're here, I'm Brock, the pewter gym leader. Sorry, I don't know what I'm saying. My rock hard willpower is epic. My Pokemon are rock hard and true grit and determination. That's right, all my Pokemon are rock type, which is horrible for us. You pick Charmander, this is going to be a very hard battle, because you're weak to rock, Charmander, pick Squirtle, or Bulbasaur, like I did. You should one-hit KO pretty much. There's Geodude, level 12. After Geodude, he does have Onix. And Vine Whip should take this guy down. Yep, one-hit KO right there. Super effective, Geodude fainted. 220 experience points. Look at that, level 14. Our attack and everything's way up there. We've got to use Onix. Onix has Rock Tomb and stuff like that, so I recommend just leaving out your starter Pokemon if it still has a tiny HP like mine does. And I'm gonna use Vine Whip again. Oh, tackle. Ah, only 4. Should KO it? Yes, look at that KO. And full Onix Painter. Bulbasaur gained 324 points. Look at that, nearly level 15. We defeated Brock. I took you for granted, so here, I lost. As proof of your victory, I confirm. I don't know, it's a broken sentence right there. You, this official Pokemon, Boulderbadge. This is the only time in the game where you actually get the Boulderbadge within the battle. Normally, it's right after they talk to you again. Just having the Boulderbadge makes your Pokemon more powerful. It also enables you to use Flash, which we don't need Flash for a while outside of battle. Of course, Pokemon must know move Flash to use it, so it's not like magically Flash. We got 1,400 Pokédollars for winning, so that's really nice. And wait, take this with you. We received PM39 from Brock. It has Rock Tomb in it. And it pretty much, it's like you teach, it's like a taught move. It's only one use only. So pick carefully. Contains Rock Tomb. It hurts boulders and lowers its speed. It uses boulders and lowers Pokemon and speed. But we're only like 5 minutes into this video, so... one thing I forgot to do up here is I think right here... Yep, we found a Pokeball. Just click A right where I'm standing and looking, and you'll get a Pokeball. You know what? I wasn't gonna show this off, but since we got plenty of time in this video... Yes, I will... yes, I'll pick it. 50 Pokedoll, that's a lot of money right there. And so right here we have Pterodactyl. It's a fossil Pokemon. The ancient Pokemon. And this guy's just telling you bones of a dragon. And right here is Kabutops, another ancient Pokemon. Right here it says Space Shuttle. In the original game it was Space Shuttle Discovery, but since Discovery blew up and stuff like that, they changed the name. Which I think was a good thing on this. Meteorite that fell from Mount Moon. Thought to be the Moonstone. And right here is July 20th, 1969. Mankind first set foot on the moon that day. I bought a color TV just so I could watch the news. Well, you know what? I'm sorry. But it came... This guy got really ripped off. He bought a color TV to watch something that was only in black and white. So, we'll leave this, because there's not much more to do right here. We're going to keep going down through Pewter City. I'm just going to make a quick stop at the Pokemon Center to heal up all my Pokemon. Even though we only have two, and I'm just, it's more for refreshing moves and damage. There's Jigglypuff right in the corner. There's a computer. If you go up the stairs, if you're playing on the old Game Boy game, you can system link and battle people. I'm playing on an emulator, so that doesn't really work for me at all. I'm just going to continue going through. And now, there should be somebody new here. Yes! Yes, somebody new! You stopped us! Oh, Sean! I'm glad I caught up with you. I'm Professor Oak's Abe, not AIDS, Abe! I've been asking you to deliver this. Here you go. Sean received running shoes from the aide, which is really nice because it didn't come in the original game. With running shoes, where you press the B button, and you run! I must be going back to the lab. Bye-bye! So, there's a letter attached. Dear Sean, here's a pair of running shoes from my beloved challenger. Remember, I'll always cheer for you. Don't ever give up. From Mom. So, there we go. We got the running shoes, and look how much faster we go running than if we're walking. So, I'm gonna try... How did you... Okay, well, I'll battle a couple of these people, and the rest I'll do off-screen. Last, just sent out Pidgey. We have Bulbasaur here. You know what? I'll fight it with just this one. But then I will continue moving around and doing other... I'll probably switch my Pokemon after he levels up. I don't want him to get too high of a level. Than my other Pokemon. I'm trying to keep all my Pokemon about the same level, which right now I'm not doing a good job of. 105 experience points, look at that. Level 15, it's amazing. He's trying to learn Poison Powder. Sure, we'll do it anyway. I really think, I think we'll get rid of the Growl. Because I think Poison Powder. 1, 2, and poof! Bulbasaur got Growl. And Bulbasaur learned Poison Powder, which I think is a better move. Bulbasaur is trying to learn Sleep Powder. Bulbasaur can't lose any more moves. No. Oh, I want to say no. I don't. Sleep. And I don't want to learn. No. Yes. Thank you. Good. I don't want him to learn Sleep Powder. Yes, we will switch out. Go to Sparrow. And we shift. Like always, good, come back. Go Sparrow! And send out Pidgey. And let's see, I will... When Sparrow evolves, I'm actually gonna prolong his him evolving, because he does learn a very, very good move. You can only get a Sparrow, not a evolved one. Which I won't spoil what its evolved form is. Let's see. I'm now stuck in this battle. That's great. Viridian Forest. Okay, I guess you could see this there. I went back and battled everybody, but who knows. But he's sending out Caterpies. You know what? We'll test out the new attack, Poison Powder. Let's see. Got poison. That's nice. Spring Shot. Not too effective. Speed Bomb. Hurt by poison. We'll see how much damage it does. A little bit. But we'll go to changing Pokemon right now. I should probably switch these right after this attack. Not attack, but this accumulation. Speed fell again. It's hurt by poison. I will use Peck. And I drop it all the way because it's a flying type. And it fainted. 155, so it's split 50-50. Weedle, no. I'm just gonna attack again. Peck. There we go. Super effective. Weedle fainted. 100 experience points. About to use Caterpie. No. Pretty much use Spearow or your flying type Pokemon, or a Pokemon that has flying type attacks. They will just destroy these things. Even if you're a little under level. I'm 4 levels higher right now. I'm a little over level. But still, it destroys. And maybe we get 120 Pokedollars for winning. But on the next time you're watching me play Pokemon FireRed with Gameonwithsean, I will continue. I'll probably off screen all these people so I can just run through here. But I will continue moving forward, and we will find out what's on the other end of this route. So, I'm Sean, signing up. See you guys all tomorrow.